Did your mum say she'd come?
Yep, and Serge.
The boyfriend?
He's not the boyfriend, he's a friend. So how many's that?
Eight. 10 including us. I thought I'd keep it pretty simple. Slab of beef, potatoes, salad, bits and pieces. I'll do the shopping tomorrow.
You could always do that mushroom and egg pie thing, that's nice.
Which?
You know, the one in your veggie cookbook. Your memory's going.
Getting old. I'll look it up.
No, I'll get it.
It's on the desk, I think.
Mm-hmm. Miles, do you find me attractive?
That's a funny question.
Oh, well, I'm a bit skinny, don't you think?
Nonsense. You're elegant. Look at all the models these days. Look, don't be silly. You are so full of life. You're sweet, you're pretty, you're intelligent. I'm sure there are hundreds of blokes who'd kill to get close to you.
Sexy?
Now I think about it. I'm sure you'd have a certain... for a lot of people, young men, believe me.
Of my place.
Right. I mean, if you were 10 years older and I was, Right. Sorry.
Don't be.
Okay. Ridiculous. That means a work only becomes art when someone pays money for it.
That's not what I said at all.
Not in so many words, but that was the implication.
And what exactly do they examine at a National Service Medical?
Well, I don't know. I guess I'll find out tomorrow.
Oh, tomorrow?
It'd be completely different if it was the politicians who were being shot at.
Quite a few of them have been, in the last war, Gorton among them. I think he's well-intentioned, just naive.
He's as cynical as the policy that took us in there. The only thing Gorton's naive about is the growing opposition to the war.
Your husband worked for Gorton, didn't he, Evelyn?
Yes.
What sort of bloke is he? Gorton.
I don't know, really. Like most politicians, he's very pleasant. You know, they talk a lot, but they don't say much.
If they stuck to talking, it wouldn't be a problem. It's their actions that cause all the trouble. Gorton's quite prepared to let the Americans use our troops as part of a global power play.
That's fair, mate. We wanted the Americans in Vietnam.
Terrified of the yellow peril.
That's a joke. Vietnam's a third world country with a simple peasant culture.
Oh, come off it. They're not all peasants. Saigon is a sophisticated place.
You've been there, have you?
Well, no. But Mum has. She was there in 65.
Only for a couple of weeks,
Oh, really? And how was it then?
Pretty corrupt.
In what way?
People were saying that Key's political campaign was funded by the drug trade.
Really?
Is that common knowledge?
I don't know. One of our intelligence people told us about it.
They say never trust a spy.
Oh, they were genuinely worried. The South Vietnamese army was falling apart at that time. And that was the dilemma facing the Americans. I mean, they could either stand by and watch the South Vietnamese be defeated, or they could go in, boots and all. I don't think they ever anticipated the stakes would get this high. You see, the Vietnamese have a different concept of time. What was it that Ho Chi Minh said? A 20-year war is nothing more than the blink of an eye.
Well, you could always chuck a sickie. It's enough for your medical.
No, I need to go to work tonight. I reckon he's a bit of a punce, Miles is.
Oh, he's all right. What do you mean?
I don't know. Farting around like he owns the world.
It was his party.
He acts like he owns you, too.
Nobody owns me.
You act like he owns you.
Serge, just because two people sleep together doesn't mean anyone owns anyone.
What?
What do you mean, what?
You're joking. You and Miles?
Oh, come on, Serge. I've slept with you. I've slept with a few people.
Yeah, but Miles? He's a bloody geriatric. You're putting me on.
Stop making such a fuss. You've slept around a bit and I never quiz you. You don't own me either, you know.
I've never slept with anyone old enough to be my bloody mother. It's disgusting. Did you have any trouble, did he? Any trouble keeping pace? I suppose it makes him feel younger, right?
Shh, stop it.
I won't stop it. Here I am, the young blood, going off to face my judgment on the knife edge of life and death, and you're off screwing the nearest pensioner.
Serge, be quiet. You're twisting it. He's a nice guy. It just happened, that's all. I still love you.
Oh. And that's supposed to make everything all right, is it? You stick to your bloody nursing home. I'll send you a postcard from Vietnam. See you later.
Serge!
It's all right, mate.
What are you on?
They've just sent me in to get a specimen, if you'd be so kind.
Well, how are you feeling?
All right, I suppose.
I'm surprised.
Well, how do you mean?
If that was your urine sample, son, I'd give you about 48 hours to live. It is an offence to willfully deceive a medical officer during an examination, punishable by up to 4 years imprisonment. But I'm going to give you a choice. Either the full weight of the law, or you produce another specimen. Now, right here. Taking care to avoid spillages.
Is Douglas in?
He's busy, I'm afraid.
Oh, not from here, I don't think. Is anyone with him?
No, but the door's strictly barred. What's your name?
Monica Montgomery. I just want to surprise him. He's bored.
No.
I'll just poke my head in and go, I promise.
Cooey?
Monica.
Oh, don't get up. Just a quick hello and goodbye.
You're not getting off that easily. Get in here.
Supercilious piece of skirt.
When did you get back?
Left Saigon Tuesday, moved back into the flat Wednesday, set aside the day for the depression that always hits me when I hit Canberra.
Can't sleep without the gunfire.
It was exciting. I miss my friends.
Listen, instead of the bar, would you like to go home for a drink?
Do you think that's wise?
Evelyn's left me.
So I heard. Even so, this isn't Saigon.
No. But we could pretend. I've never had the time to put all the material on the war together before. Not so thoroughly. The military, political, the anti-war movement. It's very exciting. It's very scary. Oh, I'll have it straight. There's no tonic. It's like a jigsaw. Every new piece seems to confirm the picture. Unless we can engineer a radical about face on Vietnam, Gordon's gone. The government's had it.
Well, what direction do you suggest we face?
I hardly dare say it. I think we've got to get out. With or without America. Cheers.
Oh, you're certainly getting reckless in your old age. The golden-haired boy's in for a crew cut if he starts spouting that sort of talk.
That's what I haven't worked out. How can I blaspheme without being crucified? Hmm. And what if I'm wrong?
Oh, I don't think you're wrong. But I don't think the executioner's going to care much either way. Douglas, I'd like to stay. But not for the night, not here.
I'd say he was going to be a bit late home for tea. Stick that on him.
What is it?
Oh, just a calling card.
Today, in the largest demonstrations the country has seen in almost 20 years. There was little conflict and police made few arrests as demonstrators marched through the streets of Sydney, Melbourne, Adelaide and Brisbane and staged massive rallies calling for an end to conscription and the withdrawal of Australian troops from Vietnam. In Sydney, estimates of the number of marchers ranged from 20 to 40,000. Police commended the orderly behaviour of the demonstrators and organisers congratulated police on their tactful handling of the march.
Year in and year out,
I... Hi, sir! Quick, you've almost missed it!
Come on! More bombs! And more bombs on Vietnam!
In Canberra, the Minister for Labour and National Service, Mr. Snedden, caused a storm when he described the moratorium organisers as political bikies pack-raping democracy.
Oh, can
the
you
Prime Minister, Mr.
Thanks,
Gordon,
Billy. There's tomorrow's car too.
He was happy that the demonstrations were peaceful, but declared that the government would never formulate policy as a result of street marches. And in other news...
Oh, we've won! We've won!
You see the tide coming before your eyes.
History in the making.
you today, but there were too many people.
Missed it. I've been lining up places to go.
Oh, it's tomorrow, isn't it? Hey, everyone, Serge has to report to the army tomorrow.
Oh, no.
What are you going to do?
Hide.
Don't worry too much. Won't be for too long.
Yeah, the writing's on the wall for conscription now.
Look, a lot of people demonstrating isn't public opinion. People see the ratbags taking over the streets and they get scared. Things don't change overnight, you know.
Yeah, well, anyway.
When do you go?
Tomorrow.
Where?
The less you know, the better.
Serge, they're not going to torture me.
I've got to handle it my way, all right?
Okay, sorry. Do you need anything? Money?
Not yet.
You know that I'll do anything to help. Anything, anytime. Are you scared?
Terrified. Going on the run's all right. It's just hard not knowing how long it's for. How long I'll last. If it goes on too long, jail might seem tempting.
No, it won't. No.
I don't know when I'll see you again, Megan.
You want to spend the night with me then?
Well, that's a good idea. You're not just doing this because you feel sorry for me, are you?
Why else?
Oh, well. That's empathy. Empathy's a very noble thing. The ability to empathise sets us apart from lower animals.
Are you planning on leaving them on?
Oh, I just thought maybe we should get to know each other a bit first.
Shooting, no cock-ups. Fast and quiet. It's not a nice village to be seen in. I'll take security outside. Knife and Marty, cover the door. Tansy and Phil, you take him. Tansy make the grab, Phil cover.
Run them with this bastard, so we got to make a stand. Marty, take the little bloke over there and make him squeal.
The rest of you, go to ground. I'll fire the first shot.
You all right, Digger?
Oh, yeah, great!
No!
please welcome the President of the United States of America, Mr. Tricky Dicky!
Hooray! I believe you want to buy one of our used cars.
Oh! Mr. President!
I'm Hot Jim in the Fly, I'm Hot Jim in the Fly, straight from
well, I've always believed the Vietnamese problem would be a lot easier if there were no Vietnamese.
Shh.
So keep it up, boys.
Yes, sir, Mr. President. Yes, sir.
Want to make a donation to the draft registers legal fund? Draft registers legal fund?
I'm broke.
Have you been over there?
Might have been.
Are you on leave or are you out?
I'm out.
What'd you think of the show?
I like Sonia's pants.
We're doing a show on the weekend with a couple of veterans who spoke at the last moratorium. But they're thinking of forming a Veterans Against the War Association.
Yeah?
Would you be interested?
Probably not.
558 Drummond Street, okay?
Okay. Good luck anyway. That's a party if you're interested in it. One of those guys will be there, one of the vets. Come along.
Thanks.
Someone came and took your love away.
Why didn't you come down and say hello?
You were busy.
At least you found yourself a drink.
No, I brought my own. Hey, mate, they're mine.
I really need a drink, man.
There was a tap in the kitchen.
Thanks a lot.
You thirsty, are you?
Could be a long night.
Why did you decide to come? You didn't like our play at all, did you?
I didn't say that.
You didn't need to.
So now you're an expert on me, are you?
All I know is you were in Vietnam. And I've got a bit of an idea what that's like.
I doubt it.
I try and imagine. Maybe you can help me.
Haven't you ever met anyone who's been over there before? One of the freaks. I'll bring your friends over. I'll do a little performance for them.
I wish you'd calm down.
Maybe you should just go to bed. Your boyfriend wouldn't mind that, would he? Not with a Vietnam vet.
I didn't invite you around here to go to bed with him. Anyway, he's not my boyfriend. We live in the same house, and that's all.
Maybe you should go to bed anyway.
You going to give me one of your precious cans?
Sure.
Mind if I have one?
Go ahead.
You're not going to arrest me or anything.
You're the one that said we had unlimited supplies over there, remember?
Gee, you're a sweet person.
How many people live here?
Four, basically. Though one of the girls is hardly ever here. She's joined the Divine Light. The fat 15-year-old with 20 Rolls Royces or whatever. Sometimes there's a few more faces here for breakfast.
The rest of you, you're in this acting thing, are you?
A street theatre? Yeah. We usually do performances at demos. Lately, we've been doing shopping centres and places where we're not just preaching to the converted. What do they think of the anti-war movement over there?
It's really good to know that everyone back home's cheering you on when you get your legs shot off.
Yeah, I can understand how you must feel really bitter.
You're incredible. You really think you know all about it, don't you?
No, I'm sure I don't.
I'm not gonna stand this shit.
Hey! Put it out!
What the hell's going
Stop.
On in here?
Bloody head!
Has he? Maybe he has. Look out!
Actually, where are you?
At home.
I tried calling a couple of times earlier, but you're out.
Having dinner, were you? Have you heard from Phil?
That's what I'm ringing about, actually. He's out of the army.
What?
Well, I only found out because one of your letters to him came back here saying he wasn't there.
Is he all right? Where is he?
I don't know where he is. But according to the army, he's having some treatment for minor problem with his eardrum, but otherwise he's fine.
Surely they must have known where he was going.
The address he gave was here, our place. But he didn't even leave a message.
There must be something else.
Look, I won't talk anymore now. I'll ring you in.
Why?
I woke you up, that's all.
She's there, isn't she?
Are you by yourself? All right, yes, she is here. I'm at her place.
Well, why did you say you were at home?
Well, it didn't seem to be any point.
There was never any point telling me anything.
You know that's not true.
Well, I'm going to start ringing the army people down here too.
Yeah.
I'll call you if I find out anything.
Is she all right?
Oh, yeah.
Why did you ring her up at this hour of the night?
I don't know. Couldn't sleep.
Worrying about Phil?
Not just Phil. A policy paper.
You're not getting cold feet.
It'll be a kind of career harikari. I'm on the outer as it is.
It does happen to be politically in their interest, if only they realised.
It's not only pulling out of Vietnam, it's the whole alliance. The fact that the Yanks have treated us like second-class citizens all along. And the facts are there, but nobody wants to see them.
You've got to stick your neck out sometime.
I wonder where Phil is.
The army would have let you know if anything serious was wrong.
Yes, but what sort of judges are the army about the effects of a war like this?
You've got to put in that paper, haven't you? You're not going to want to live with yourself if you don't. I don't think I'd want to live with you either.
There's no way Hanoi will go with it while Chu's still in office. That's always been one of their conditions.
Just got a message from the White House. Nixon's announcing details of a proposed truce in about an hour.
When did this come through?
Literally in the last few minutes.
Basically, it's a standstill ceasefire to allow peace negotiations to get going. Mutual withdrawal of North Vietnamese and Allied forces.
Here's the clarification. Laos, Cambodia, and South Vietnam okayed the plan when it was first mooted. 6 months ago.
This is like a deja vu of March 68. We weren't given the courtesy of a telex that time. When LBJ announced the peace negotiations and the bombing freeze, we heard about it in the press.
I don't think that's particularly helpful at the moment, Doug.
With respect, I do think we need to take a serious look at this. We are in there with the Americans. We need to know what they're doing. We are just not being told.
What exactly are you saying, Doug? We all know from your paper you've got your doubts about Vietnam. You're beginning to sound now like you've got your doubts about the American alliance.
I think that we should protest about this repeated lack of consultation. Surely we can at least be given the opportunity to express our own opinion.
I'm not sure the State Department would appreciate your tone of voice, Doug.
Oh, for God's sake, we are a sovereign state. I mean, we just can't echo everything America says.
Calm down, Doug. We're all Australians here.
I also believe that we should settle on a date for the complete withdrawal of our task force.
We are phasing things down, Doug.
We're not replacing the 8th Battalion.
I really don't think the South Vietnamese Army can last long on their own.
I think they can.
I think they will prove a paper tiger.
What's your evidence for that?
The war is being lost even with the Americans because they have lost the support of the Vietnamese people and of their own people back home. Now, Nixon knows this. He is pulling out because politically he has to. We are in the same boat.
We're not wholly locked into political expediency, Doug. We're not in Vietnam to win votes.
Right.
Yeah, all right. They are pulling out also because militarily they have to. The war is unwinnable. Which means that our troops are over there dying for no reason.
I think we're being sidetracked. We need to give strong support to this peace initiative, and we need to reiterate our commitment to hold our ground. Now, let's see if we can flesh something out.
Right, I've got some notes here that might help.
Oh, mate.
How are you, mate?
I'm good. I'm good. I wouldn't mind a bit of light on the subject, though.
Of course. I'll turn this off, eh? Hey, grab us both a beer, will you?
What, through here?
Yeah. How long you been back? Yeah?
Oh, not long. They kicked me out.
You're in one piece, mate. That's good news.
Hang on, mate.
Thanks.
Want a smoke?
No. When'd you take that up?
Oh, I figured if I could survive a war, I could risk a bit of smoke in my lungs.
We're under the flight path. It's a bit of a dump. Haven't had time to do it up yet. Have to go to hospital for operations every so often.
Okay.
They're not going to get me out of this. I don't notice any difference. How about you?
Killing time.
Yeah.
I don't know. I can't get used to it.
I sometimes wake up in the middle of the night. I think I'm there. The noises are different though, and the smells. I realize where I am.
Yeah. I had that for a while. Waking up and thinking I was still there. Then I'd try and get up.
Hello, Phil.
Remember Leigh?
Hi.
Did you ask about the beer?
Yes, I think they understand.
Have you got an ashtray?
Yeah, in the kitchen, mate. It was a niner, right? Not an 18er.
A niner.
You have to come along, mate. Some of the old cricket team are coming around on Sadiavo. I was the wily off spinner. Ashley Mallett had nothing on me. No one could ever pick my wrong one. Jack's an orange, mate. Grab one for yourself.
You stay for dinner, Phil?
No. I've got something on.
If you come on Saturday, it's nice. Because I don't know anyone else.
You're the one that wanted to have it.
Yeah, so you can see your old friends.
Sort of a back from the dead get together. Let people know I'm still here. Haven't had many visitors since I got back. Not that I wanted any.
I'll go then.
I don't mean you, you bastard.
Yeah, all right, I'll come.
Good one.
Mrs. Goddard, it's out of my hands. I'm simply not at liberty to divulge personnel files.
Surely I can at least find out the extent of his injury.
Oh, as I told you before, his injury is listed as minor. A perforated eardrum.
Well, how can I find out where he is?
Mrs. Goddard, excuse me for asking, but were you on good terms with your son?
Of course I was. We've always been a close family.
Well, as I informed your husband, the only contact address he left was your former residence in Canberra. So we have no additional information as to his whereabouts whatsoever.
Where do his pension checks go to?
They're paid direct into his Canberra bank account. And of course he can draw on those wherever he is in Australia. I'm sorry, Mrs. Goddard. I really can't be of any more help.
Hi. The door was open.
Well, what are you doing here?
I thought I'd come down for the day, call in and say hi.
How about you stay the night? We'd be pretty unlucky if the cops gave us a visit today.
No, I don't know. I'd feel a bit awkward staying here.
Why?
Because of you and Miles.
Oh, I told you that finished ages ago. It was never anything anyway.
G'day, Serge. How are you?
Good. Good, thanks, Miles. How are you? All right?
Great. Great.
Good. I am actually really tired. I went to talk to this peace group in Orange last night. Didn't get back till nearly 4 o'clock.
What's the mood like in the country? Places like Orange would be pretty hostile, wouldn't they?
Oh, no, there's some fairly active groups in some of the bigger country towns.
Oh, why don't you come up to my room? Get a couple of hours sleep.
Keep up the good work.
Yeah, okay.
So good to see you.
Is it? I almost didn't come, you know.
Guess what? I met this guy who does gardening around this area. I'm going to start working for him next week.
Great.
Well, that means I can stop working at that sleazy bar. What's the matter?
Who's the guy?
Oh, God, Serge. He's a Buddhist. He's into celibacy.
Maybe that's what I should be.
Certainly feels like it.
Actually, I'm getting less tired by the minute.
Really?
How long was I asleep?
A couple of hours. Was it a bad dream?
They're always bad. It's nice waking up to you, though. Be good to get a place together now, wouldn't it? Don't you think?
I'm not sure.
Why not?
Oh, maybe it's easier just having our own places.
I thought you said things had finished with Miles.
They have. I'm just enjoying living here. Being able to be on my own when I want to. It's having breathing space after being trapped in Canberra for so many years.
You going out with someone else at the moment?
You've got a one-track mind. No, no one specially.
Oh, right. So there is someone casual, right?
Oh, God, Serge. I go out with a few people, like you do.
I just thought, it's so easy between us. I thought, yeah, maybe it's time we started to do something a bit more serious. Sounds like a funeral, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does a bit. Let's just see what happens. I'm feeling really good about things at the moment. And I do like being with you, so there's no need to get paranoid.
Oh, mate. Just jealous.
Some of these other ones are getting burned, but you turn them over. The sausages, okay?
Well, even money. They won't Laurie back.
Bold Nile.
Tens.
Laurie?
Yeah?
Well, it's 10 to 1.
Right.
What's his wife's name again?
Lay.
Good lay, you reckon?
Bit of decorum, Des. You're a married man.
Oh, look, we can all dream, mate. Give us the tolls. You're going to get the salad, okay?
Not much money for the stayers in the race, such as Citadel, Polar Trek, and Dane's done. They're expected to get too far back out of the race in the early stages. And so they're all drifted from around about 20 to 1 out to somewhere in the order of 50 to 1.
I reckon 50% of the blokes over there got the clap three or four times over.
Clean.
Oh, I didn't mean her.
It'd be hard for her having to speak English all the time. Not having anyone around speaks whatever they speak over there.
Chinese.
It's not Chinese, you bloody idiot. They speak Chinese in China.
Vietnamese.
Same difference.
But as far as the big money's been concerned, it's all been for well oiled and the only one confidently supported.
Dressing?
Yes, in the fridge. That's mayonnaise. Do you know what dressing is?
Dressing?
For the salad. Vinegar. Do you know vinegar? Oil?
No vinegar.
I'll have to go to the corner shop and get some. Can't serve lettuce without dressing.
I go.
You can't go. You're the hostess. Tell Laurie not to serve the meat till I get back.
Enjoying yourself?
Oh. Yes.
You like it here, do you?
Yes. Because it's peace.
Do you want a drink?
Yes, please.
It was absolutely terrifying. And then this crazy anarchist with a huge red beard called Lindsay Smith got up the flagpole.
Hi, Deb.
Hello.
Hello, Roger. Mm.
Hi. Oh, hi. You're coming on the march.
Doesn't seem like a betrayal now Phil isn't there anymore.
Have you spoken to Dad?
Yes, no news.
Yeah. I'm going to try the repat hospital.
Oh, well, I'll come with you.
Right.
Went and saw 5 easy pieces last night.
Jack Nicholson was fantastic.
You should have come.
I went out to dinner after my Italian class.
Who with? Don't be so nosy. I'm not. I'm just interested, that's all.
It was just one of the other students.
Was he nice?
Quite. Bit of a one-track mind.
Oh, just wanting to get you into bed.
He did have one other topic of conversation. He's into sports cars.
Oh,
got this old MG that he kept raving on about all night.
You gonna see him again?
I haven't decided. He's quite good looking. Serge isn't going on the march, is he?
Mm-hmm. He's gonna wear that mask.
Still taking a chance.
No, I won't march either side of him.
Bodyguards.
Bouncers.